What I want to do in this video is find the arc length of one petal, I guess we could call it, of the graph of r is equal to 4 sine of 2 theta. So I want to find the length of this portion of the curve that is in red right over here. And we'll do this in two phases. First of all, I want to set up the definite integral for finding that arc length, and then we'll evaluate it. And I'll actually use a calculator to evaluate it because it'll be a little bit more straightforward, at least for this integral. So let's just start with that. I encourage you to pause the video and, knowing what we know about the formula for arc length when we have it in polar form, see if you can apply it to figure out this arc length right over here. So I'm assuming you've had a go at it. So let's just remind ourselves that the arc length is going to be the integral from our starting angle to our ending angle, so we'll call it from alpha to beta, of the square root of the derivative of our function with respect to theta squared plus our function squared. Plus our function squared d theta. So let's figure out what r prime of theta and what r of theta actually are. So maybe I'll color code it. So we know what r of theta is. Actually, let me just rewrite it. So we know r of theta is equal to 4 sine of 2 theta. So r prime of theta is just going to be derivative of 2 theta with respect to theta is 2 times 4 is 8. Derivative of sine is cosine of 2 theta. And so if we wanted to write the definite integral for arc length, it's going to be equal to the definite integral. Now what's our starting bound? Well, for the petal that we care about, we're going to start at an angle of 0 radians. When we have an angle of 0 radians, r is 0. That's this point right over here. So we're going to start at 0 radians. And we're going to go all the way up to pi over 2. When sine of 2 times pi over 2 is sine of pi, which is 0. So we get back to this point right over here. So we're going to go from 0 to pi over 2 to pi over 2 radians. It's going to be the square root of, give myself some real estate here, r prime of theta squared is going to be this thing squared. So it's going to be 60, let me do it in that same blue color. So it's going to be 64 cosine squared of 2 theta. And then plus this squared, which is going to be 16 sine squared of 2 theta. And then, of course, we have our d theta. And you can attempt to solve this or evaluate this analytically. It's not too straightforward. So I'm going to use a calculator. And this gives us practice with knowing that, hey, you know, there are tools out there that can help us do these types of things. So I'll go to the definite integral. Let's see, I go to a second calculus on my T85. I pick this choice, which is for the definite integral. And so let me express what I'm taking the definite integral of. So it's going to be the square root of 64 times cosine of 2 theta squared. So cosine, and I'm going to use x instead of theta, just because it's an easier variable to use on my calculator. So let me make sure my parentheses are good. So I'm going to say cosine of 2x. Cosine of 2x. All right, I'm close that. And now I want to square that. All right, I did that first part. Plus 16 times sine of 2x, close that, squared. And actually, I already see, let me make it sure. I'm not sure if the calculator knows to interpret that as multiplication, so let me insert a times right over here. So 64 times cosine of 2x, that thing squared, plus 16 times sine of 2x, that thing squared. And now let me go to the end. And then that's And then let me close my radical. So that's going to close that right over there. Or that closes what I'm taking the square root of. And then comma, the variable that I'm integrating with respect to is x in this case. Everywhere I saw theta here, I'm just replacing with an x there. And I want to do it from, instead of theta equals 0 to theta equals pi over 2, we'll say x is equal to 0 to x is equal to pi over 2. Pi over 2. And hopefully I have not made a mistake when I've typed this in. And I get, it's chugging on it a little bit. And we get, will it actually come up? Oh, finally. All right. So if we were to round it, let's say to round it to the nearest thousandth, it'll be 9.688. So approximately 9.688. And let's just see, does that make intuitive sense? Let's see, it goes as far as 4 away. So if you just went out to 4 and then back down, that would be about 8. But of course we've actually gone out some. So it actually makes intuitive sense that this arc length would be 9.688. Anyway, hopefully you enjoyed that.